as a child and as a teenager, I wasn't particularly confident. In fact, I was pretty much the exact opposite. I've dealt with periods of very bad anxiety, as I know a lot of young girls particularly do. And I think that's something, being open and honest, I still struggle with that sometimes. The pressures that I place on myself and that a lot of society can place on young girls whilst you're trying to find out who you are can be very taxing and very difficult, but I think it's important to try to keep those in perspective. For me, ways how I've overcome that was honestly being uncomfortable, forcing myself to do the things which I knew made me anxious and made me scared, and alongside that, having people around me to support me through that. I had phenomenal friends, family, and even teachers who were able to pick me up when I fell, but also encourage me and push me to make myself a little bit uncomfortable.
I am, along with so many others, constantly thinking about where we'll be in 5 years, in 10 years, even in 50 years' time.
When I spoke at the TEDx Youth Conference in Sydney, I was 16 years old at the time, and this was one of my heaviest times of anxiety. Leading up to that speech, I'd said yes, and I was determined to, you know, put myself out there, but it was also public speaking was one of the most terrifying prospects to me. I worked myself up a lot about it. I had a lot of panic attacks, was shaking before I was going on stage, but I was fortunate enough that I had those people around me to encourage me, to help me in every way possible. Once I'd finished that speech, standing there on stage and just really looking out over the audience, I had a great sense of accomplishment in myself, not for the fact that I just, you know, delivered a public speech, but for the fact that I think I had overcome something in myself. And it was just the first step to surpassing that period of anxiety. And I think you got to remember that it always is a steps. It's never going to be one thing which changes in an instant.
Now, I know that I'm going to fail and I'm going to be disappointed constantly. But when this happens, it just means that you need to get up.
Probably should have said this. Ironically, I actually walked off stage and fainted straight afterwards.
You see, that was a great speech and don't know I was shaking beforehand and fainted afterwards.
If I was to give any advice to young girls about believing in themselves, as cliche as it sounds, it would be to believe in yourself. Yes, you may not always necessarily feel like you have the confidence or like you are worthy or like you can do anything, or you might be worried that you're going to fail. But those are all just thoughts in your head. My advice would be to take that first step, even if it is a baby step, and then have the people around you to support you to continue taking those steps, and never stop.